Good day everyone, I'm Jewel and this is J7409 weather. Yes, my goodness, we've had severe weather over the past few days. It was confirmed now that there were three tornadoes up around the Dallas, Texas area in the past few days. One of them was an E3 with winds of 140 miles per hour. Then we had one in Arkansas, which took the life of a person. Now we're looking at today. Where is the greatest threat of severe thunderstorms and possibly tornadoes? Well, it's looking like thunderstorms capable of locally damaging winds and tornadoes are possible across parts of central and eastern North Carolina into the Tidewater region of Virginia this afternoon into early evening, as you can see right in here. And then it's a marginal outlook all the way down from Florida all the way up into parts of Washington, D.C. and Maryland. Now, so far as the tornadoes itself, looking like this area again is having the biggest threat of this weather happening with significant winds up to 15%. That's a very good chance of high winds coming. If you do have these thunder showers popping up, and some could make up into tornadoes if you get one of these supercells coming across your area. So please, please be aware. As we see in the hazardous weather outlook, this is for eastern North Carolina, counties of Martin, Pitt, Washington, Terrell, Mainland, Dare, Greene, Beaufort, Mainland, Hyde, Duplin, Lenore, Jones, Pamlico, Northern Craven, Southern Craven, Inland, and Onslow. A few strong to severe thunderstorms are possible this afternoon. The primary threat with these storms is damaging winds, but an isolated tornado or two is very possible. Please, folks, keep your eyes on your skies if you live in any of these areas. If you see anything that looks like it may be forming, make sure you have a safe place to go to if needed. Now, as we check the watches and warnings map right quickly, we can see these high winds are still going on through parts of the Dakotas, some of Nebraska, a large portion, just about the whole state of Iowa, a big portion of Minnesota, some of Illinois, and some of Wisconsin. And also, we've got some very high winds going on in the Great Falls area of central Montana. And here we have a winter storm watch going on in Colorado. Now, this is kind of a head up, folks. It's a heads up, so go ahead and be ready for it if you live or are going to any of these areas for the winter storm watch. It's in effect from Wednesday evening through Thursday morning. Where? Teller and northern El Paso County, including Pikes Peak, the Rampart Range, and Monument Hill. Now, heavy snow is possible. Total snow accumulation, 6 to 12 inches possible across the mountains, with 4 to 8 inches possible across the lower elevations. Once again, this is from Wednesday evening through Thursday morning. If you have to commute in those areas, it's going to make things very difficult, and expect rapidly deteriorating conditions early Wednesday evening with slick and snowy roads overnight through the Thursday morning commute. The wind advisory is going to remain in effect until 6 p.m. this evening, where in portions of central, east central, south central, southeast, southwest, and west central Minnesota. Northwest winds 25 to 35 miles per hour with gusts up to 50 miles per hour. Now, this windy condition is going to last with you until around 6 p.m. Central Daylight Time this evening. The tree limbs can be blown down. There could be some power outages. So, and if you're driving, especially in a high-profile vehicle, you know, to please, please be aware and be safe. So the wind's going to blow virtually all day long in these portions of Minnesota today. Now, for much of north central Iowa, along and north of Highway 20, and along and west of Interstate 35, High wind warning remains in effect until 10 a.m. this morning. This is a high wind warning. Then after 10, a wind advisory will kick in from 10 a.m. and last through 4 p.m. this afternoon. High wind warnings, northwest winds 30 to 35 with a few gusts over 50. For the wind advisory, west winds 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 45 miles per hour is what you can expect. Damaging winds, they can blow down trees, power lines, isolated power outages are very possible, and travel will be very difficult. So please keep this in mind. Now, the strongest winds are expected to occur through early this morning. Here's a check of the GFS map. This map this morning we're using courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. This is Tropical Tidbits map. You can see the timestamp right here, so we will turn it on and let it roll. And you see this big, strong, low-pressure system. It's currently near Lake Superior, and it's going to continue lifting northeastward over Ontario through midweek. Now, although most of the rain has stopped across the upper Midwest, the winds, like I've showed you, are going to continue to be an issue from the eastern Dakotas to the greater Chicago metro area through tomorrow. And this is all due to this very tight pressure gradient in place. Now, the high wind warnings, of course, as I've showed you, are in effect for this morning across portions of northwest Iowa, southwest Minnesota, and eastern South Dakota. And these winds, once again, can gust in excess of 55 miles per hour. Numerous showers and some thunderstorms are expected across the east coast region today, along and ahead of this cold front. Now, there's going to be enough instability ahead of the front across parts of eastern Carolina to support the development of strong to severe thunderstorms, maybe also some tornadoes. But the flash flood threat appears to be limited at this time. Elsewhere across the U.S., valley rain and mountain snow is expected across the Cascades and the Northern Rockies today, and then the Central Rockies by tomorrow. Sunny to partly cloudy conditions are expected to continue from California to Texas, with below normal temperatures across the Rockies and Plains and slightly above normal for California. And that is a check of your weather today. Thank you so much for joining me and checking out the weather with me today. I appreciate it so much. Don't forget to subscribe, click the bell, and then check off all. Thank you for the comments, the thumbs up, and everything you do for me. Don't forget to share this information also. I love you guys. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and much peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.